Cameron!
Damn it! Not a moment of peace.
You would be justified in passing me the bread.
It's old, honey. I just wish that they...
Baby?
I'm afraid it's very serious. In your career, have you ever had contact with a brand of movie makeup called prolactin?
Well, I don't know. What is it?
It's used to make fake semen.
Oh, crap.
Well, at any rate, your body is now 99% cancer. You have less than a day to live.
Don't worry, baby. I'll find love again.
Thanks.
Baby, is there anything special you want to do before you, you know, kick it?
As a matter of fact, there is.
Oh, that's all right. Okay. You know, I thought maybe we'd cuddle.
Yeah?
Thanks for making Lucy Liu cry on the set of Charlie's Angels, Bill Murray.
Yeah?
For giving me cancer with your fake semen, Ben Stiller.
I was just an actor. That stuff gave me cancer, too.
Well, thanks for having cancer.
Yes?
Where's John Rutter? I'm gonna hit him in the nuts for blackmailing me over those topless photos.
You'll have to go visit him in prison.
Oh, yeah. I won that case. When does he get out?
4 years from now.
You win this round, John Rutter's nuts. Come on. Plenty of Cameron for everybody. That's right, people. Closer. You're gonna want a really good photo of this. Burn in hell, you dickless ass clowns.
Didn't the dead paparazzi get a memorial too?
Yeah, it's right. It's right over there.
This is a robbery! Fill this bag with inconsequential bills!
Wow, I'm getting robbed by Nicole Richie!
Shut up! I want to go to prison to save my friend Paris!
For a robbery? They might just fine you for that.
Good point.
Stupid celebrity. Armed robbery and murder. You'll be locked up for 45 days.
Am I locked up? Perhaps it is you who are locked up, and I am truly free.
Shut up, you bitch! Get out of my head! Ah, she's in my brain!
Nicole, is that
like
you?
Paris!
I couldn't let my best bud slash meal ticket rot in jail. Now could I? Wink.
But now we're both locked up.
Don't worry. I had an escape plan tattooed on me.
I recognize those symbols.
They're words, Paris.
What?
Give us the guard.
Good.
Oh, you're the right guard. Unlock my cell. My vagina cell.
Chaining you.
Yeah.
Whew. That was great, ladies, but now you gotta go right back into your cell.
Forgot to use the poison.
Why does that keep happening to all my boyfriends?
You should really see a gynecologist.
We now cancel Cavemen to bring you breaking news from Linwood Prison. Noted celebutards Paris Hilton and Nicole Richie have escaped. Viewers will recall that Nicole Richie is the daughter of famous musician Lionel Richie.
Nicole, it is over! You got nowhere left to run!
The joke's on you! I weigh 62 pounds! I can glide through the air like a spider monkey!
Up, up, and away, Falcor!
No!
Yay! Yeah. I could really go for another one of those. Where is our cabana boy? Paris!
Oops, I did it again. With my vagina.
Laughing makes me hungry.
Bear Grylls here. Today I'm going to show you how to survive in a truly exotic environment. Behind me are Matt Dillon, Neve Campbell, and Denise Richards from the movie Wild Things. What you want to do is distract Matt Dillon by talking about how good he was in Drugstore Cowboy. Then you finger bang the girls under the water while the Jets hide it all.
Who are you?
You know, you were just incredible in Drugstore Cowboy.
Oh,
Thanks, man. This is the best hot tub ever.
Oh, really branching out from TV?
And remember, a bird in the hand is worth a hand in two bushes.
And I declare Sammy Shrimp Shack the real winner. See you next time on Man vs. Food.
Hey, Adam, great episode today.
Shut up. I just ate 12 pounds of popcorn shrimp.
What the hell? Where is my toilet?
You'll never hurt me again. Yeah. Freedom.
Oh, no. Oh.
Oh, God.
And split.
This is going to make a fantastic commercial, Jean-Claude. Just hold that pose.
I can do this all day. My pubic muscles, they are strong.
What the? Oh! What the hell was that giraffe doing there? Are you okay?
I am a professional.
Ah, my testes. Are you driving through a zoo of only giraffes? Ah, what?
Ah! Call the paramedics!
Who knew it would be giraffes what defeated Jean-Claude?
Stop! Stop! Ah!
Volvo.
Hello! Welcome to my pipe store, sir.
Hey, you're the white rap kid from 90210. You're Brian Austin Green, right?
Well, I used to be an actor, but now I'm following my true love. Pipes!
Oh, yeah. Now that sign makes a lot more sense.
Now, can I help you find a pipe?
Say, didn't you used to date Megan Fox?
That was a long time ago.
What happened?
I told you, man. Pipes are my one true love.
I need a box to ship some antiques.
I'm sure I can help you with that.
Hey, you're Megan Fox, the actress.
Former actress. Boxes are my life now.
Didn't you used to date that, Austin Greenbrier or whoever?
Brian Austin Green, yeah. But these days, boxes are my one true love.
Excuse me, miss. Do you have any boxes that would fit my heart?
Well, I know when I'm a third wheel.
You mean all this time, you were running bagpipes next door?
You're the owner of Fox's boxes?
I guess that some things are just meant to be.
And together, they formed the most successful pipe shipping company in the United States. Yeah, well, that ends the 46th and final season of Masterpiece Theater. Toward the end, I became very confused about what this show was trying to accomplish, and quite honestly, PBS viewers grew outraged their pledge money was funding it. I'm not sure what I'll do with my career in the months and years to come, but I can guarantee you I won't be bookending tales about Brian Austin Green running a f***ing pipe store. Oh, did I go off script? Did I ruin your precious take, you insufferable prick? Brian Austin Green can swing from my balls. Get a good grip, Brian! You've destroyed Masterpiece Theater! You f***ing destroyed it!
So, we still have a lot of those tote bags left.
Michael Bay presents Explosions! Explosions from Michael Bay!
Sucked.
Jeez, tell the whole theater, why don't you?
An evening devoid of nightmares and dreamscapes.
Well, hey there, Kingsley.
Dean Koontz?
That's me. Hope you like chills of that caliber, because old Koontzie just bought a place down the road. Of course, it ain't quite as nice as your house. Foundation's a little creaky. Doesn't really hold water, but same neighborhood, right? Ooh, got an iPod, eh? Old Koontzie went with the Zoom. Almost as good. Not quite as well reviewed. Doesn't quite get the shelf space an iPod does. But it costs the same, which is weird.
Yeah.
Always room for second best, I say. So you got a car that looks just like Christine. Lot of iconic images in your books. I don't know about all that. Old Koontzie takes the bus. Not quite as fun getting from A to B, but it's an easy ride.
How did you find out where I live?
Hey, what would you say to a Koontzie King collabo? Koontzie and King, that's got a nice ring to it.
This conversation's over.
Now hold on, Kingsley. You just let old Koontzie worry about the ending. I don't want the Koontzie King collabo ending with a giant frickin' spider.
Oh, it won't.
Hey, now watch it. Looks
like your evil car killed another one, Mr. King.
What a tragedy. We've lost one of America's authors.
No use asking questions about the supernatural. Right, officers?
Of course, Mr. King. Have a nice day.
Stephen Hawking used quantum mechanics to predict radiation from black holes, but can he see what makes Cinnamon Toast Crunch so delicious?
Help, my manager has power of attorney. I don't want to be in commercials. All I want to do is...
eat more Cinnamon Toast Crunch!
Oh, good heavens, I shouldn't have taken so much melatonin last night. Wait, where am I?
I'm Julia Child, and today I'll demonstrate how to cook the French classic bœuf bourguignon.
Get away!
Today I'll teach you the French way to kill and cook a zombie. Start by shoving something big into its mouth to prevent a bite. Don't be shy, shove it in there.
Yeah.
Next we have the choice of fire or decapitation. The French prefer...
quivering? Ah, come on!
Decapitation. As a fiery zombie, running around the kitchen can be messy. Luckily, I keep my kitchen katana handy. And you'll want to cut from front to back to sever the spinal column. Now, cooking's not for the faint of heart. And bon appetit.
You know, it just, it never looks as good as hers.
Let's be firm this time. The fate of the Transformers franchise depends on it.
Mr. Bay, please put on some pants.
I hear you have some issues with the script for T5.
Yes. Well, the story seems rather nonsensical.
I approve these changes myself. See, this scene here, Prime reveals he is from the planet Magnetron.
But Optimus Prime is from Cybertron.
No, I explain all that here. He arrived on Cybertron as a boy.
Autobots aren't ever children.
And met the Autobots in high school.
There are no high schools on Cybertron.
And he invented transforming in Metal Shop.
That's absurd.
And he holds the patent, so the Decepticons owe him a lot of money.
Now, Mr. Bay, that's enough. We at Hasbro. Mr. Bay, please, my sinus is... oh, Mr. Bay, I must protest. Mr. Bay, please.
Martini, gentlemen?
We are not in a festive mood.
More for me.
We have no further notes. Thank you.
You know, Mortimer, people always ask me, where do you get the balls to make a movie that awesome? And I always respond, not balls. To make movies this awesome, you need a prehensile penis.
Bartender, give me a scotch, a backup scotch, and a boiler scotch. That's a shot of scotch floating in a bigger glass of scotch. Now scotch me, scotch face.
Wow, are you Scottish?
I am U.S. Senator Ted Kennedy.
I'm Jenna Jameson, the world's most famous porn star. What's wrong?
Celebrities in politics. Schwarzenegger, Ventura, Franken. Soon bloated, repulsive politicians like me won't find work anymore.
Hey, celebrities take work away from honest porn stars, too. Paris Hilton, Pam Anderson, Screech.
What the hell's a Screech? Aw, screw it, Jenna. If my family's taught me anything, it's that there's only one good way to get rid of somebody.
Crash their plane into the ocean?
No, the other way.
Drive off a bridge?
No, I'm talking about...
Paris, get that cock out of your mouth. That's my job.
Remember when I said I'd kill you last?
No, I don't recall that cock.
Oh, you were doing a line from my movie.
I lied.
I know how it goes.
Ah! You suck! Sayonara, Scotch.
Screech.
Whatever.
Nikes!
Hello?
Beth, honey, are you at the Oscars?
No, Mom, I'm watching them at home.
Why aren't you at the Oscars?
Because, Mom, I wasn't nominated.
When are you going to start doing prestige pictures?
I do work I'm proud of!
Apparently a little fellow named Oscar thinks differently.
God damn it!
This is the greatest day of my life! Oh, baby.
This is Bob Barker, ending my last show, reminding you to help control the pet population. Spay or neuter your pets today. So long, everybody. Hey, Phil, have you spayed or neutered your pet today?
Nah, I'll do it tomorrow.
You really should do it today.
Whatever.
I'd say that's $30 for the hedge clippers,
right.
$12.48 for the hair trimmer,
right.
And $18.29 for the chloroform.
Right again, Bob.
I've never felt so alive. All those years of talking about it, and now I'm actually doing something about it. No more hairballs for you. Come on down!
Horses are at the starting gate.
And they're off!
With the help of flowers and some Barry White, we hope Django will finally impregnate Ming Li and save the species.
Yo, boss, this is crazy. We gotta watch our backs if we're gonna save our sacks. You got a plan?
The mysterious castrating vigilante has struck again. In an unrelated story, the annual dog show starts today.
This dog show's a no-show.
I expect better manners from my guest, Bob.
You? I should have known.
That's right. And there's no way you're gonna shizzle my nizzle.
It's for the good of the pet population.
You know, Bob, I have to hand it to you.
What's that?
You're nuts.
I'm 83 years old, stupid. I've been shooting dust for years, but I wouldn't mind a replacement.
My nuts!
You're in deep trouble, friend. Balls deep. Spay or noodle your pets today.
Fuck you, Bob.